Hello students, experiment number 2 is clipper and clamper circuit. So in unit number 1 we started with the PN junction diode. Now we discuss in the experiment number 1 we discuss about the VI characteristics of PN junction diode. Now we will move towards the application of a diode. So various applications we know about the diode. Applications are in the clipper and clamper circuit, then various wave shaping circuits and then in rectifier circuit. So today we discuss the most important application of that diode, that is in the clipper and clamper circuit. So clipper, as the name suggests, it will clip some part of the input waveform. If it is clipping the positive part, then it is called as the positive clipper, and if it is clipping the negative part, it is called as the negative clipper. Now in the lab we will perform the experiment of clipper. So first see the circuit for the clipper. It consists of, as it is the application of diode, consists of diode, and you will connect one resistance here. So this is the circuit. We have connected one resistance and we have connected the diode. So we may connect one diode, two diode or three diodes depending upon the how much part we want to be clipped. Here we are connecting here the three diodes. So we will see the operation of this circuit to the input. This is the input side and this is the output side. Input is applied as a sinusoidal waveform. So we will use the input to the circuit is sinusoidal waveform. So this waveform will be generated by the function generator. So first we will hear the requirement of the to perform this particular lab. The requirement is we will need first the circuit, then we will need the function generator, and to observe the waveform we will need the device, that is CRO. So function generator, we will it will produce the waveform, the sinusoidal waveform. So input waveform is applied to the circuit. So the input waveform of 5 volt having the amplitude 5 volt is given to the circuit. Now we will see the operation of the circuit during the two cycles or two phases, during the positive half cycle and during the negative half cycle. So during the positive half cycle, during this particular part, means this is the positive, this is the negative. During the positive half cycle, see the position of the diode, whether the diode is forward bias or reverse bias. This is the manner in which we have connected the diode. So positive here, negative here, means here it will be given positive, here it will be given negative. So the cathode it is positive, the anode it is negative. That means diode will be off. It is reverse bias. Reverse bias means off. So therefore, the equivalent circuit will be, this will be the equivalent circuit. Diode will be off. So output will be, as it is a off, diode will be open circuit. So output will be same as that of the input. So therefore, in the waveform, it is clearly visible that during the positive half cycle, if input is a sinusoidal having the amplitude 5 volt, the output will be same. Output will be same as that of the input having amplitude 5 volt. So this is the output of the positive half cycle. Now let's see the operation of this circuit during the negative half cycle. So during the negative half cycle means here it will be negative, here it will be now positive. Now diode will be in the cathode, it is negative. Negative is connected to the negative, positive is connected to the positive. Diode will be forward bias. Forward bias means short circuit. But as we discuss or as we know, it is not the ideal diode. It is a practical diode, practical silicon junction diode. So it will take some time to turn on. Silicon diode starts conducting at 0.5 volt and fully conduct at 0.7 volt. Now here we have connected the three diodes. So if you consider, suppose this diode starts conducting at 0.5 volt or 0.7 volt. Suppose if I consider that, suppose the diode starts fully conducting at 0.7 volt. So voltage drop of each diode 0.7, 0.7, 0.7 means this diode will start conducting at 2.1 volt. So, but before that, the diode will be, it is as good as open circuit before this voltage. So that means whatever may be your input, the same will be the output. Whatever may be the input, the same will be the output, because even though the diode is forward biased, but it is acting as an open circuit because it is off now. And as the voltage across the diode is 2.1 volt, as we are connecting here the three diode, then it will be short circuit. Short circuit means whatever the voltage now, for three diodes the voltage will be 2.1. So it will be short circuit. So it will be clipped here. And as soon as the voltage is below the 2.1, again it will act as an open circuit. Whatever the input, same will be the output. So therefore we will get the output in this manner, means this is the portion, this part is now clipped. So therefore this is, as the negative part is clipped, so therefore negative part of the input cycle is clipped, so therefore it is called as the negative clipper. Now if I want to perform the positive clipper, in that case we have to just change the position of the diode, then it will clip the positive part. Now if I want to change some voltage, if I want to clip it at 0.7 volt, in that case I'll just connect one diode. If I want to if I want to clip it at 1.4 volt, in that case I'll connect here the two diodes. So depending upon the application, whether at what particular voltage or what particular part we want to clip, accordingly we will connect the diode. And whether we want to clip the positive part or whether we want to clip the negative part, we will connect the, that will be the diode position. That depends upon the diode position. Now we will perform it on the circuit. So requirement to perform this particular lab is, we will need the CRO to observe the waveform. We will need the function generator. Function generator will generate the waveform. It can generate the waveform of various shapes, that depends upon what we are selecting. It can generate the sinusoidal triangular sawtooth waveform. Here we have selected the sinusoidal waveform. It is clear. Here we have selected the sinusoidal waveform. So this is the frequency knob. This is the amplitude variable knob. I'll connect at this port. It will give you the input to the circuit. So this is through the function generator. One cord is connected. And as we want to observe it on a CRO, so to the CRO, we may select, this is the CRO, we may select the channel X or channel Y, any channel. Here they are, it consists of the two channel. I have selected the this channel, and we have select, the connection is between the function generator and CRO. We will generate the waveform of amplitude 5 volt. Peak to peak amplitude means 10 volt. So here, you can observe here the channel 1, we are using channel 1 here. The amplitude is here 5 volt, and this is the waveform of total peak to peak 10 volt, which is visible here. Now as it is necessary to see the connection first, because we want the to see the amplitude whether it is perfect or not, first we will observe it on a CRO, and the same input will be now connected to the circuit. So you can see here the waveform from function generator is generating the waveform, which we have observed it on a CRO. Then it is connected to the circuit. It is given as an input to the circuit. And then we will observe the waveform. We will connect the probe at the output of the circuit, and it will be observed on a CRO. Now here we can see here the input waveform is sinusoidal, and this is the output waveform. Here the negative part is clipped, that means it is performing the negative clipper. You can see here the, if I'll connect at the input side, this is the input waveform, and connecting at the output side, it is the clipping the negative part, it is a negative clipper.
So next application of diode is clamper circuit. The clamper, as the name suggests, it will clamp the your input waveform. Or we may say that another name for the clamper is DC level shifter. It may shift the DC level to the, if it is shifting towards the positive side, it is called as the positive clamper or positive DC level shifter. And if it is shifting towards the negative side, it is called as the negative clamper. In the negative clamper or in the clamper circuit, the most important devices or the circuit element which we are using are diodes and capacitor. In case of clipper, we will use the diode and resistor. But remember, in case of clamper, we will use the diode and capacitor. Capacitor will store the value. So let's see the operation of the clamper circuit. Again, the Klamper circuit consists of capacitor and diode. This is the input side and this is the output side. The input which we are giving is the sinusoidal waveform. Again, this waveform is generated by the function generator. Output of the function generator is given as an input to the circuit, and the output of the circuit is given as an input to the CRO to observe the waveform. Now let's see the operation during the negative half cycle. Means here it is negative, here it is positive. Diode will be forward bias. Forward bias means short circuit. That means now the capacitor, the current will flow, and this capacitor will charge to the maximum value of input. So if the input is Vm, then capacitor will charge to the maximum value of Vm in this fashion. So here it is positive, here it is negative. And then during the positive half cycle, during the positive half cycle, what will happen? This diode will be, here it will be positive, here it will be negative. Diode will be now open circuit. Open circuit means off. What will be the output in that case? Apply the KVL to the circuit to find out the output. Negative to positive rise means it is Vm. Then to the capacitor the voltage is Vm. Negative to positive rise, therefore we will write Vm. And we want to find out output voltage from positive to negative. It is a drop, so it will be minus V0. So now it is 0. So V0 will be equal to twice Vm. So output will be equal to twice Vm. So in the waveform, you can see here, this is the input and this is the output. So here, output is twice Vm. Twice Vm means, here the DC level, the output, the input has been shifted by the input of, positive input of Vm. So it has been shifted by the twice Vm. Vm plus Vm, twice Vm. So it has shifted the DC level on the positive side, so it is called as the positive clamp.
Again, for the circuit we will need the same. We will need the CRO to observe the waveform. We will need the function generator. Generator will generate the sinusoidal waveform which is given to the circuit as an input. And this is the output. It consists of the capacitor. It consists of the diode. And this is the output terminal. We will observe the output at the CRO. Now, at first glance we can see that in case of clamper circuit, the input and output will, the shape will remain same. It will retain the shape, but it just shift the level, DC level. So therefore, we will, here there is a, on CRO, there is a one button, DC level shifter. So we need to press that button to observe the waveform. So when I press the button, in that case, it just indicate the shifting DC, exact DC level of that particular signal. So now when I pressed it, it's clear to you now that the DC level has been shifted. When I unpress it, it will remain as it is. Even though it has shifted, but its shifting can be visible only by pressing this particular button. So we have shifted it by Vm. So your output has been shifted upward by Vm. So this is the clamper operation.